40 in Coffman County. If you're along Highway or Interstate 30 or Interstate 20 or US 80, 175, you are still out ahead of the severe thunderstorm activity and you are in harm's way. The thunderstorms are likely to catch up with you. They're running at 40 to 55 miles per hour now in terms of progress over the ground, and we're getting 70 to 80 mile per hour wind gusts well in advance of the storm lines. 434 WBAP, I'm Mark Watkins along with Chief Meteorologist Brad Barton. Our team member stations have joined our coverage as we continue. Alan Spaya is in downtown Dallas. Thank you. 65 miles per hour, the leading edge of the storm near Terrell, moving east rapidly at 45 miles per hour. All North Central Texas stations affected by this alert are requested to rebroadcast the preceding announcement. Meteorologist Brad Martin along with Mark Watkins here in the WBAC Weather Center. Live continuous storm coverage here on WBAC and our key stations as well. The leading edge now of the storms on radar from Celeste through Rockwall through Terrell down through the Gulf Springs Sigaville area through Lancaster, Red Oak. Strong storms on top of Red Oak right now. We've also had, and I'll mention this because a lot of people follow these storms on their own radar services, free or otherwise, and I can tell you we've had some radar outages as well. But again, the leading edge of the storm now from Greenville down past Rockwall through Terrell, Oak Ridge, through much of Coffman County, Sigaville, and storms continue to produce damaging outflow wind gusts along the Dallas-Ellis County line just south of the city of Dallas. 4:59 at WBAC. Eric Bushman joins us as we continue our coverage. Eric?
Yeah, Mark, I'm right now at the intersection of Field and Olive Street, just due north of
the 24/7 News Desk. I'm Mark Watkins. Good afternoon. It has been
We will have reports on the weather and Chief Meteorologist Brad Barton after we check in with Monty Cook, who's got a list the Bengals to the fore. ChrysleraChevrolet.com right now, private equipment.
That is the truth. I said about an hour ago in Fort Worth, if you were on a freeway, it wasn't. Well, now I'll just tell you, if you're anywhere in the Metroplex, it's probably not moving so well. We're at 25 southbound at I-20. That's what it is because of a wreck there. Solid back to speed a little bit better. I-20 eastbound was shut down. Both sides are absolutely there. I-30 eastbound, Rose Hill got one of the clearing stations in Irving. 161 northbound around 183. You've got a couple of lanes taken away. Also, a wreck northbound.